This is the first video of a two-part series. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to use Numpy Select to identify days when the index daily percentage change goes up or down certain percentage. Then in the next video, I'll walk through step-by-step on how to display non-English text in matplotlib. Let's dive in. First of all, read the file. This file variable stores the file location. Your file might be in a different directory. Shift Enter. Then I create a table that's based on this stock file. I assume that you've processed this file like having date open, high low close volume, which is like date open, high low close volume. Something like that. Just put in some data. You might have a big chunk of it. You need a package called pandas. You see me import here and call it pd. So it is pd.readExcel. Then read the file, which is from the file location. Then my index will be date. Here I use df.tail and then shift enter to get the last 5 rows of record. Let's say if I want to know the daily percentage change, here the percentage change is coming from this line of code, df, which is the table. To retrieve its column, we use a square bracket to wrap around a quote, and then the column name. Why is it a square bracket like this?
Indeed, it's very similar to that in Excel.
Let's say this column is day change, volume, something like that. Just put in whatever number, Control T, and then create table with header. Here you see, I select the whole column. It's table 1 because it's an Excel generated name. Table 1, table 2, table 3, and so on. Then you see square bracket day change. Isn't it very much like the day change in pandas? The only difference is the double quote. If I pick volume, you'll see the name volume on top. Now let's calculate the percentage change. Here we have a formula percentage change. We take the df.close column and apply the percentage change. Inside the bracket, hit Shift Tab to read the coding. By default, the period is 1. Then I create the label column. Rerun it. If it goes up 1 to 4%, I call it up 23. If it goes down between 1 to 4%, call it down 23. Here I create a new column called label, df label. Here is equal to np. This numpy is coming from the import numpy at the beginning. Numpy select a condition. When a triggering event happens, it will go for a particular choice. The choice is here. When no condition fits, then returns normal. Here we have 2 conditions. The first one is between underscore 23. Let me call it 14. Change this one as well. Here you see 2 brackets. The first one for day change, more than 1. That means today's close goes up more than 1% from previous day. For the second bracket, here you see me use and to join the conditions. When it's more than 1% and less than 4%. Move on to the next one. Let me call it N1N4. 2 brackets again. The first one is for day change less than negative 1, which means drop more than 1%. More than negative 4, which means dropping less than 4%. Shift Enter to rerun it. Conditions here become between 1-4 and between negative 1, negative 4. We need 2 labels to match with the 2 conditions. The label is simply the choices. Remember, the first condition matches with the first choice. Let me call it up 14. Then the second condition will be N1, N4. The condition name is totally up to you. Shift Enter. So we just define the condition between 14, between N1 and 4. Then put it inside the condition variable and match with the choice label. for Jan 31st and Jan 28th, the close has gone up 1.05%. So it fits the condition of going up between 1% and 4%. So it should be 1.4. Here, 1.4 down N1, N4. On Valentine's Day, Feb 14th, it drops 1.7% from the previous day, Feb 11, which fits the condition of dropping between 1 and 4%. For those not meeting any conditions, this one down less than 1%, name it normal. This one less than 1%, normal. Here I can freely change, let's say up to 2 to 4%, or drop 2 to 4%. Then I'll get signal when it goes up 2 to 4% or down 2 to 4%. For Feb 22nd, usually I'll use this label to identify specific period to focus on. This is the threshold. Only go further when it exceeds certain percentage. Alright, that's it for NumPy Select.